Since the dawn of the Industrial Revolution, fear of automation has been on the rise. In the early 1800s, textile workers in England got spooked by the rise of weaving machines and sparked a rebellion so intense that the military had to be called in to put it down. When the automobile was invented, people worried about what it would mean for the horse industry. And when the first computers were introduced, office workers fretted about bookkeeping and other jobs that had previously been done on pen and paper. And who could blame them, really? Those machines were coming for their jobs, man. But if you think about it, most of the great inventions of the past 200 years have been designed explicitly to take our jobs. And yet, the fraction of people in the workforce is near an all-time high. So, what gives? If machines keep taking our jobs, and they do, then why are there so many jobs left over? What are we getting wrong? The fear of machines goes back even further than the Industrial Revolution. When the printing press was invented in the 1400s, people worried about the church scribes that would be out of work. Back in the 1500s, Queen Elizabeth vetoed a patent on a knitting machine for fear that her subjects would lose their jobs. Whenever a new technology arrives, we can easily see what jobs it might replace. The problem is that we're really, really bad at envisioning what kind of new jobs might be born in the future. For example, it's true that computers eliminated the need for typesetters who used to place type by hand, but they created demand for graphic designers who set type, well, it's still technically by hand, but it's fancier. The idea is that when we passed off some of the workload to machines, it broadened the scope of what was possible. We came up with new ideas, new innovations, and new kinds of work. In fact, many of the industries that are around today, like electronics, health, medicine, finance, and insurance, barely existed or didn't exist at all a century ago. I mean, imagine trying to explain what an app developer does to someone in the 1960s. But focusing on machines that will replace jobs doesn't appreciate how they might actually strengthen them. For example, when ATMs started rolling out in the 70s, they threatened to make human bank tellers extinct. But banks quickly found that ATMs made it cheaper to open new branches, and the result was more branches and more tellers than ever. Since the arrival of ATMs, the number of bank tellers has doubled. Why? Well, once bank tellers were freed up from dispensing cash, they started forging relationships with customers, solving problems and introducing them to new products like loans and investments. The net effect was that bank tellers became more valuable to banking. But that's the past. What about the future? Automation is accelerating and spreading to more industries faster than we've ever seen before. Machines are increasingly replicating skills that we once thought were unique to humans. AI algorithms are trading in the stock market, recommending products to us, and guiding airplanes through the sky. Robots are being developed that someday might be cooking your meals, running warehouses, or performing surgery all by themselves. So, is this time different? Luminaries like Elon Musk seem to think so. He's predicted that soon, robots will be able to do everything better than us. And Stephen Hawking has warned that artificial intelligence will replace humans completely. Lots of people seem to think it's only a matter of time before these ever smarter machines make most of today's workers obsolete. So, should we be worried? So, is it different this time? Well, yeah, it's different this time. Just like it was different after the printing press was invented, or the assembly line, or tractors, or computers, or any invention that changed the world. All of these new technologies transformed the way we work, and adjusting to them wasn't simple, costless, or immediate. But if the past is any indication, this radical leap forward in technology is at least as likely to create jobs as it is to destroy them. Even if these new jobs might sound as strange to us as an app developer does to someone who's never seen a cell phone before. Put simply, there's no way for us to understand right now what those new jobs might be in the future. And for many, that's a frightening leap to take. So what do you think? Should we be worried? Or is a fear of 21st century automation once again getting it wrong? Subscribe to our show page and be the first to see new episodes of Wrong.